Welcome back to the adventure. Today we're taking XP mode from Windows 7 and upgrading it to Vista. XP mode for Windows 7 is a virtualized instance of Windows XP that has integration features in the operating system. For example, we can take a document that was written in Office XP and open it right from the Windows 7 desktop. The integration is seamless compared to booting up the entire operating system in VirtualBox or VMware. So I had the idea that because it's Windows XP, it can be upgraded to Windows Vista. So I decided to give it a shot. Now, this process did take several hours to complete. So just to talk about the numbers real quick, the host system has a 6-core processor and 16 gigs of RAM. Allocated to the guest running Windows 7, we have 3 cores of the processor and 6 gigs of RAM. For XP mode, we have it set to its maximum of 3.5 gigs of RAM. So the reason this took forever is because it runs out of system memory and it goes to cache things to the hard drive while it's installing, which is much slower. This got me thinking that the host system has more resources than what's allocated to the guest, and the guest has more resources than what's allocated to XP mode. So is it virtualizing the issue where it's running out of memory and having to cache to the hard drive? Yeah, I think that's what it is. It's virtual slowness. So like I mentioned, this process took several hours to complete. I did eventually get it to upgrade to Windows Vista. However, it had this very strange issue where I couldn't sign in. I was required to set a password in XP mode, so I have to enter a password to sign into Windows Vista. The cursor will momentarily flash in the field for entering the password, and then disappear. I'm unable to type, I'm rebooting the system, I'm changing the amount of memory that's allocated to it. I really ran out of options and was about to throw in the towel, when suddenly one of the reboots worked. Now I do remember working with Windows Vista way back when it was brand new, there were some issues with the initial boot. It would take an incredibly long time to do whatever it was doing in the background, and then eventually the system would run normally. And I believe that's what happened here, is I ended up leaving the machine running long enough that it eventually caught up and I was able to type in the password. So we have Vista on the system now, we're able to boot into it, we're able to open the document in Office XP. So let's try that integration feature to see what happens. And of course that did not work. Now, working with Windows Vista long ago, there were some things for XP that would run normally under Vista and other things would not. I suppose these integration features are just one of those things. So researching this on the internet, it's obviously been attempted before, and they came to the same conclusion that I did. It's simply not possible. The integration features just are not compatible with Windows Vista. So we may visit this at some point, tinker around with it more, see if we could get it to work. But for now, it's just not possible to have a Vista mode running on Windows 7. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.